Welcome to our travel and tourism, education tourism video YouTube channel. Our YouTube channel provides you worldwide tourist destination information in micro level. Indian Tourism Development Corporation Introduction. In India there were monasteries and dharma inns to accommodate travelers. Travelers, scholars, expatriates, and merchants stayed there. The hotels were run on the fees they paid. Ancient Buddhists were the first to build safe places for travelers to stay. Cave temples in many parts of India were places of worship and accommodation for Buddhist monks. The Buddhists built monasteries in quiet places. They were engaged in worship. They provided accommodation and food for the travelers who came to them. The embankments were located on important roads. Inscriptions indicate that some merchants accepted the administrative cost of the temples. These houses were used as hostels by merchants. Became the money-saving houses of the merchants. There were also food roads in religious shrines. There were cooks on the dining roads. The Afghan Emperor Tirzajari built highways. He set up food roads after a certain interval in the printing press to protect business and travel. Similarly, the Mohammedans built such restaurants all over their country. Later kings, nawabs, great merchants, and benefactors built restaurants to facilitate travel. Safe accommodation and restaurants have proliferated as trade has grown. The roads provided food and security for the passengers, as well as fodder for their horses. The look of the hotels inns have become contemporary hotels with the aim of catering to the needs of travelers and travelers. It took place according to the quality of life and lifestyle of the people. In 1744, David Lowe started the first family inn in London, Covent Garden, the former home of Lord Archer. Since then, new hotels have sprung up in London, Brighton, and Boston. The first hotel in Switzerland was built in 1820 AD. As the number of train passengers increased, so did the number of hostels. Hostels also proliferated in urban areas as employment increased. People who went to see the orgies held in the cities also needed accommodation. So the rich built a variety of hotels. Expression of hotels. Hotels appeared from the American restaurant. Hotels became the abode of the rich and famous in France. City halls and bars were provided as hotels. In 1800 AD, terms such as restaurant, hotel, and coffeehouse were used interchangeably. The word hotel was also adopted in 1820 AD. People there received food and shelter at night. American hotels became gathering places for merchants. Hotels at that time were not graded. In the 19th century, hotels served as venues for meetings and conferences. In 1830, Henry Kelo was appointed head of the Baltimore Hotel. The hotel had 200 separate rooms. Today, one-third of the total revenue of American hotels is earned by holding meetings and conferences. Hotels play an important role in the development of the tourism sector. It is very difficult to upgrade a tourist center without hotels. The central government, the state government, and the private sector of the major tourist destinations in India have set up various hotels to help tourists enjoy their leisure time. Tourism in India has grown rapidly since the 1960s. So a committee was set up under the chairmanship of J.A. to advise on tourism development. The JAC committee submitted its recommendations in 1963. The central government should pay more attention to the tourism sector. The JA committee recommended the formation of three corporations, the Indian Hotel Corporation, the Indian Tourism Corporation, and the Indian Tourism Transport Corporation. Accordingly, the above three corporations were set up by the Government of India in 1965 under the Companies Act, 1953. Building and managing hotels. All three clubs did important work, such as providing transportation and assistance to tourists. But then the Government of India decided to merge the three corporations for reasons such as economic austerity, efficiency, cooperation, and systematic planning. Accordingly, on October 1, 1966, the three companies merged to form the Indian Tourism Development Corporation in Delhi with the support of the Department of Tourism. On the recommendation of the Administrative Reforms Committee, Azoka Hotels, Janpet Hotels, Lodi Hotels, and Runjeet Hotels were merged with the Tourist Corporation of India on March 28, 1970. India Tourism Development Corporation is a government public sector undertaking. Objectives of the Indian Tourism Development Corporation. The objectives and functions of the Tourism Development Corporation of India can be categorized as follows. Establishment and maintenance of hotels, motels, restaurants, guest houses, beach entertainment centers at various places for the convenience of tourists. Providing international transport facilities for tourists. Conducting musical performances, sound and light shows, proms, etc. for the enjoyment of tourists. Advertising to highlight the heritage and cultural significance of the country in order to attract travelers from neighboring countries. Establishment of supermarkets where all the necessary items for tourists are available. Provides tourism-related management services in India and abroad. Tasks of the Indian Tourism Development Corporation. The Indian Tourism Development Corporation has been doing a lot of excellent work. Has been making efforts to generate the manpower required in hotels, snack roads, and other sectors of tourism. To this end, the association has set up 21 hotel management and hospitality technology companies and 15 culinary training institutes in the country. These companies offer charter classes in hotel management and cooking. These courses range in duration from 6 months to 1 year. Through these classes, the manpower required for the tourism sector is available. The company also runs some companies to promote adventure tourism. There is a National Water Sports Institute in Goa and an Indian Mountaineering and Flying Training Institute in Gulmarg. It also runs classes in Ali, Patnatop, Gulmarg, and Kullu. Indian Tourism Development Corporation. The Tourism Development Corporation of India also classifies star hotels in the country by data, 1 to 5 stars. It is thus classified once every 3 years. This is why hotels and restaurants are approved and one is set up. The committee is made up of representatives from the central tourism, state governments, accommodation, and tourism associations. As of March 2000, there were 1,164 hotels in India. They have 72,156 rooms. All of these hotels are approved by the Department of Tourism. There are currently 157 one-star hotels, 377 two-star hotels, 356 three-star hotels, 94 four-star hotels, 62 five-star hotels, 54 five-star deluxe hotels and 64 traditional hotels in India. These hotels are doing a great service to tourism development. In pursuit of the above objectives and tasks, the Tourism Development Corporation of India is promoting tourism in collaboration with the Central Government Ministry of Tourism and Aviation. The museum, which had 129 rooms and only 50 buses in 1969, now operates efficiently with more than 3,000 accommodation rooms and more than 300 buses. So growing with freshness. The activities of this association have multiplied after the recognition of tourism as a separate sector in India. The Tourism Development Corporation of India has set up a sales division at its headquarters in New Delhi to cater to tourists. Has been operating with the aim of commercializing to Indian Tourism Development Corporation. Introduction in India. There were monasteries and dharma inns to accommodate travelers. Travelers, scholars, expatriates, and merchants stayed there. The hotels were run on the fees they paid. Ancient Buddhists were the first to build safe places for travelers to stay. Cave temples in many parts of India were places of worship and accommodation for Buddhist monks. The Buddhists built monasteries in quiet places. They were engaged in worship. They provided accommodation and food for the travelers who came to them. The embankments were located on important roads. Inscriptions indicate that some merchants accepted the administrative cost of the temples. These houses were used as hostels by merchants. Became the money-saving houses of the merchants. There were also food roads in religious shrines. There were cooks on the dining roads. The Afghan Emperor Chersajari built highways. He set up food roads after a certain interval in the printing press to protect business and travel. Similarly, the Mohammedans built such restaurants all over their country. Later, kings, nawabs, great merchants, and benefactors built restaurants to facilitate travel. Safe accommodation and restaurants have proliferated as trade has grown. The roads provided food and security for the passengers, as well as fodder for their horses. The look of the hotels inns have become contemporary hotels with the aim of catering to the needs of travelers and travelers. It took place according to the quality of life and lifestyle of the people. In 1744, David Lowe started the first family inn in London, Covent Garden, the former home of Lord Archer. Since then, new hotels have sprung up in London, Brighton, and Boston. The first hotel in Switzerland was built in 1820 AD. As the number of train passengers increased, so did the number of hostels. Hostels also proliferated in urban areas as employment increased. People who went to see the orgies held in the cities also needed accommodation. So the rich built a variety of hotels. Expression of hotels. Hotels appeared from the American restaurant. Hotels became the abode of the rich and famous in France. City halls and bars were provided as hotels. In 1800 AD, terms such as restaurant, hotel, and coffeehouse were used interchangeably. The word hotel was also adopted in 1820 AD. People there received food and shelter at night. American hotels became gathering places for merchants. Hotels at that time were not graded. In the 19th century, hotels served as venues for meetings and conferences. In 1830, Henry Kelo was appointed head of the Baltimore Hotel. The hotel had 200 separate rooms. Today, one-third of the total revenue of American hotels is earned by holding meetings and conferences. Hotels play an important role in the development of the tourism sector. It is very difficult to upgrade a tourist center without hotels. The central government, the state government, and the private sector of the major tourist destinations in India have set up various hotels to help tourists enjoy their leisure time. Tourism in India has grown rapidly since the 1960s. So a committee was set up under the chairmanship of J.A. to advise on tourism development. The JAC committee submitted its recommendations in 1963. The central government should pay more attention to the tourism sector. The JA committee recommended the formation of three corporations: the Indian Hotel Corporation, the Indian Tourism Corporation, and the Indian Tourism Transport Corporation. Accordingly, the above three corporations were set up by the Government of India in 1965 under the Companies Act, 1953. Building and managing hotels. All three clubs did important work, such as providing transportation and assistance to tourists. But then the Government of India decided to merge the three corporations for reasons such as economic austerity, efficiency, cooperation, and systematic planning. Accordingly, on October 1, 1966, the three companies merged to form the Indian Tourism Development Corporation in Delhi with the support of the Department of Tourism. On the recommendation of the Administrative Reforms Committee, Azoka Hotels, Janpet Hotels, Lodi Hotels, and Runjeet Hotels were merged with the Tourist Corporation of India on March 28, 1970. India Tourism Development Corporation is a government public sector undertaking. Objectives of the Indian Tourism Development Corporation. The objectives and functions of the Tourism Development Corporation of India can be categorized as follows: establishment and maintenance of hotels, motels, restaurants, guest houses, beach entertainment centers at various places for the convenience of tourists. Providing international transport facilities for tourists. Conducting musical performances, sound and light shows, proms, etc. for the enjoyment of tourists. Advertising to highlight the heritage and cultural significance of the country in order to attract travelers from neighboring countries. Establishment of supermarkets where all the necessary items for tourists are available. Provides tourism-related management services in India and abroad. Tasks of the Indian Tourism Development Corporation. The Indian Tourism Development Corporation has been doing a lot of excellent work. Has been making efforts to generate the manpower required in hotels, snack roads, and other sectors of tourism. To this end, the association has set up 21 hotel management and hospitality technology companies and 15 culinary training institutes in the country. These companies offer charter classes in hotel management and cooking. These courses range in duration from 6 months to 1 year. Through these classes, the manpower required for the tourism sector is available. The company also runs some companies to promote adventure tourism. There is a National Water Sports Institute in Goa and an Indian Mountaineering and Flying Training Institute in Gulmarg. It also runs classes in Ali, Patnatop, Gulmarg, and Kullu. Indian Tourism Development Corporation. The Tourism Development Corporation of India also classifies star hotels in the country by data, 1 to 5 stars. It is thus classified once every 3 years. This is why hotels and restaurants are approved and one is set up. The committee is made up of representatives from the central tourism, state governments, accommodation, and tourism associations. As of March 2000, there were 1,164 hotels in India. They have 72,156 rooms. All of these hotels are approved by the Department of Tourism. There are currently 157 one-star hotels, 377 two-star hotels, 356 three-star hotels, 94 four-star hotels, 62 five-star hotels, 54 five-star deluxe hotels and 64 traditional hotels in India. These hotels are doing a great service to tourism development. In pursuit of the above objectives and tasks, the Tourism Development Corporation of India is promoting tourism in collaboration with the Central Government Ministry of Tourism and Aviation. The museum, which had 129 rooms and only 50 buses in 1969, now operates efficiently with more than 3,000 accommodation. Thanks for watching the Indian Tourism Development Information. See you in the next video. Till then, take care.